How you doing, everybody? I'm Terrible T-Kid 170 from the Boogie Down Bronx. Repping Wild Style, the Nasty Boys, TMT, the Magnificent Team, TDS, to name a few. I remember being a little kid and on Burnside Station, I remember seeing some kids tagging the inside. That was in the late 60s, bro, believe it or not. That kind of planted the seed. I remember, you know, just walking home and stopping at the bodega, getting a soda, and then, you know, with a little El Marco mark, I was tagging King 13 on the icebox that they're in front of the grocery store, the bodegas. I mean, today, man, the cats are amazing. They're freaking amazing with all the techniques and everything. I mean, I come from the school when the only thing you had was bone caps, Niagaras, and Jaffones. I remember I did a big T because they called me Big T because I was tall and skinny and looked like a T and stuff. And they called me Big T like that. And because I was always the youngest guy, man, they called me Kid too. So I remember I did a Big T Kid. And then I took out the big and kept the T Kid and I became T Kid 170 in 1977. And I found myself loving going into a tunnel, going into a yard by myself and pulling out cars, man. The excitement and the thrill, it was amazing, man. And I remember ever since then, I used to like hop on the train and ride in the front car and look out the window. And when it would go in the tunnel, I would fantasize like I was going off to some fucking other place and whatnot. You know, it was just like an adventure for me. To me, it was like exploring, going into the tunnels and seeing all this stuff all over the place, seeing all these old tags from old riders and shit, man. I mean, it was amazing, man. It was amazing. It was a whole different time. And just the excitement of being in that tunnel, painting, being in that ghost yard, painting. I was alive. Like all my senses, man, they just like came to life. Like I knew if somebody was coming, you could feel it. You knew when a train was coming, the wind would blow. You could hear the mice, the rats, the roaches. You could hear them, man. You know, I did it to get away from the neighborhood. I did it to get away from the gangs. Cause I grew up in the South Bronx when the Bronx was burning. You know, it wasn't a lot of opportunities for guys like me. In fact, I'm a miracle because I survived that environment. It came from the lowest of the low. And it's elevating to the highest tops that there is, man. Corporations love what we do. They hire us to do stuff. Before we were chastised and cast aside, we were outcasts. Even though it was illegal at the time, today it's not. It's not just about being aesthetically pleasing. It's more about making a statement and letting people know that, you know, there's always something that we can fix, that we can work on when it comes to society, when it comes to life in general. What I did for the Museum of Graffiti, and what a freaking honor that is, man, to have a museum dedicated to graffiti, man. You know, my hat's off to you guys. And it was just like, yo, you know what? I'm gonna give you a flavor of every episode or era that I lived through, from my beginnings to where I'm going now. It was an honor doing this, and it was fun, man. It was fun. Today, I'm 59 years old, man. I'm still rocking this shit, man. I don't see myself stopping. The one thing about me that I always do is I do graffiti. I never called myself an aerosol artist, spray can artist. I've always considered myself a graffiti writer.